by the year 2050, we will need to feed a planet of more than 9 billion people with less land, water, fertilizer, and fewer pesticides. Scientists worldwide are racing to develop new innovations to address these challenges. We are running out of time, but many think agriculture is the problem, not the solution.
The USDA says the meat people don't have to tell you what's in it.
Some people believe food should be produced as it was 100 years ago. The pastoral image of food production resonates with consumers. Controversy sells. The media focus on controversy and will tell you agriculture uses or is responsible for 25% of all greenhouse emissions, 40% of Earth's arable land, 70% of our fresh water, rather than tell you how far we've come with food innovation. To produce a bushel of corn, we now use 35% fewer greenhouse emissions, 40% less land, 50% less water than we did 30 years ago. Farmers and scientists have made enormous strides to improve agricultural production, but we need to do even better. It is not enough that we survive. We also want people and the planet to prosper. To do this, we need sustainable agricultural practices, and that means change. Change can be scary, but we need to advance food production or everything will change, for the worse. If we want the public to embrace agricultural innovation, scientists need to change how they communicate science. Agriculture is both the greatest threat and the greatest hope for the future of our planet. Together, we will answer the question, can agriculture save the planet before it destroys it? Join Jack Bobo at the APS annual meeting, August 5th through 9th in San Antonio, Texas, to learn why we need to be part of the conversation on agriculture. APS, changing landscapes of plant pathology.